Hey, welcome back. Part number four of my 32nd scale Viggen build. Now this part, we're gonna basically get to this stage, get down and dirty and get the main assembly done. And you see it's a beast. By the end of the video, we're pretty much up to the stage right here. So looking good, let's go ahead and get started. All right, welcome back and quick kind of update where I'm at since the last episode, or part should I say, is I've got this guy together and sanded it all down and looking very smooth and looking really good. Obviously once you prime this, you're not going to see the lines and stuff. Also apologize, been painting, as you'll see in a minute, so I've got paint all over my hands. So getting down on inside the intakes here, obviously a sanding stick wouldn't reach, so I went to Home Depot and touching various sanding papers, I found that this 320 grit 3M, these get six sheets in here for about $5, was actually really good grit for what I wanted, obviously, because we're just sanding away the filler. We're not like taking huge chunks of plastic away or resin away, should I say. So sanding them all down and really smooth, liking how that's looking. I've put the very nicely detailed nose gear bay in. Simple, just a few parts to add. I did lose one clear part, I got one light, snub light on the other side I lost. Might show up some point, if not, no big deal. Glued this in with some super glue and perfect fit perfectly, no problem at all. So that's done. Now I'm not going to do anything more here, as I mentioned last time, because I want to really work on getting the main assembly done. There's going to be a lot of dirt, a lot of mess, sanding and filling and that kind of stuff. So I'm going to work on to get the fuselage done. Once that's all done, get the wings on, and then we'll finish up with the front here, because obviously this is self-contained, no problem at all, so we can leave that to the very end. So we'll continue working our way back and get this beast done. It's going to be pretty long. So I honestly can't remember if I talked about this last episode, but the main kind of fuselage part here, cut these parts out, no problem at all, just with a little bit, basically with a knife, just scored it and pushed out the flash. Now, did sand down the edges here. This is where the main gear bay goes in, and it was kind of layered. It was a little bit messy, the resin where it's cast, there's some like gaps and stuff. So I did some filling, a little bit of filler as you can see there, sanded it back on both sides, and we're good to go. And then, not sure if it's the right side, let's see. But yeah, I might got lucky. So then these guys just go in. Actually, no, I got the wrong side, so this goes in this way, should just kind of click in, there we go, like that, and it'll just be with some epoxy, I'll just glue those main bays in, just like that. Now, that's kind of caught you up, and then working on the very back, the exhaust tube here, painted with, look at my paint here, dark iron, 214 Mr. Metal. See the glare in the light. So first I primed it with my black Mr. Surface of 1500 black, and then misted it on this guy. So I've got like the main tube, and then at the end there's gonna be a fan blade, which is just two parts. This part you have to cut out, 3D printed and glue it onto this part here, the casted part, and I think it goes, geez, this way around, isn't it? And it basically slots into here, the back. So this was painted steel, and then using the same dark iron, just mitted some on around there, and also some jet exhaust from Alclad, again, just to kind of, just a little tone differences and kind of get it kind of a little bit dirty and stuff. You see it looks pretty cool. So that's done. And then finally, the big 3D printed end piece, bit of a beast. So there's a couple of configurations. You can have like the petals here kind of fully closed. I got this one open for a little bit of visual interest. And painted steel around the back, and then on the blades too, and then dark iron again on the inside. I did paint steel on these guys first, because I was wondering if the paint would go through, you know, into the inside. So I painted those first, we just masked them off once we paint the whole main fuselage. And then I painted the inside afterwards. So what's gonna happen is, get this the right way around, basically slots in like that, and you got that goes on the back like that, and that's your kind of back end. And then this then is going to go onto here, and then that goes onto here, and then you're getting an idea of the size of this. No, still nose cone to go on, but you're getting a size of how big this guy is really going to be. So we're already at about 45 centimeters with no nose cone. So we're going to be about 50 centimeters long. So one thing I did do too is also my props on, if I reach across. This guy with my sanding drum we talked about last time round. This again, it's all gnarly on the inside of this. So just taking this and just working my way around, see how thin it is, just sanding it back, because it wouldn't fit otherwise, so I can fit this piece in so it fits on. So again, you know, it's a little bit kind of rough textures and stuff in there, so just took the sanding, like, nice slow speed. I think this was the 120 grit, and just, yeah, took away all the insides and cleaned it up, and these rails where it slides and stuff, just to make it a little bit more better fitting, pretty much. And that catches you up where I'm at. So what I'm left really now to do is kind of putting these things together. So a bit of a long introduction, but what I'm going to basically do is, off camera, I'm going to get my 5-minute epoxy, and I'm going to glue these guys in on here. I'm going to glue this onto the tube, then a tube onto there, complete that, and then once that's done, we can then marry up the two parts and get this this back section done. Then once that is done, we'll go ahead and attach, you know, bring the whole thing together. So that's the game plan. Let me go ahead and start gluing some of these stuff together, and I'll be right back. All right, so this big heavy club is put together. Literally just finished epoxying the front half. So there we are, and yeah, looking good. So a little bit of a step and a gap around the back here, not too much. Obviously it needs to be taken care of. And the main one's this main join here. And you can see if I turn it this way, with a good mill or two smaller on the back half and we're on the front. So it's going to definitely need some, a lot of work. So it's just filling around there and just getting rid of that step. Again, you can see there, you see it's just not lining up. So it needs to be sanded down and blended. We're going to lose a lot of detail for sure. But obviously, you know, we need to take care of that and the two seams there. So just give an idea of the size of this beast. Let me zoom out a little bit more. And I've got a wing. Now, I've not sanded this or anything. I just kind of just cut off the block. And you can see there how big this guy's going to be. It's going to be absolutely awesome looking. But just off the top here, the fit's actually really nice for this wing. Now, some people I know on the forums are complaining really bad fit for the wings, but I've not really sanded this down. I've cut off the block, did a little bit of scraping, but you know, it looks actually pretty, not bad fit at all. You know, looks pretty good. So again, it's going to be quite the beast. You can see the cutting mat here, kind of size. It's definitely taking shape. So again, the wings are nothing really happening there. Just cut them off the blocks and give me an idea of what's going on. So yeah, it's almost kind of late at night here, so I'm probably going to think what to do here, the gaps. I'm probably going to add a little bit of filler around the back here and the front, just a little bit of Tamiya. Kind of show you in a little, just put a Ziploc bag so it doesn't dry out. And just a typical basic Tamiya putty. See, it's like the gray color. And just with a cocktail stick or a toothpick, just take a little bit and just rub it around. I'll do that, like I say, before I go to bed, so it dries overnight, gets a really good dry, and then we'll wet sand it in the kitchen sink. We'll wet sand it back, and hopefully those seams look good. And once that seams are done, like I said, then we can work on the wings and doing more assembly here and building this out. So really just the wings, the canards, which probably maybe can go later on, we'll see, and obviously the tail as well. But yeah, taking shape and definitely heavy. It's got to be a good 4 or 5 pounds already. But hopefully that landing gear does take the weight. So I'll put this filler on and come back tomorrow and we'll see where we're at. All right, so here we go. We are done, looking really good. Took care of the seams. And As always, wet sand. Tamir putty really likes being wet sanded. So let me do a quick video. I never included it before, and I'm going to kind of show you real quick what I mean by wet sanding. And that's literally just under the kitchen sink there, water running, and just sand it down, and it sounds real nice. All dust goes straight down the kitchen sink, and no mess anywhere. So it makes it super easy, super clean up, and yeah, looking really good. So that's how I'm my wet sanding, basically, and got rid of these seams. I got a little bit, see here, I got a little bit, needs more work doing, a little bit cracked, and I got to fill it in and take care of that, but that's not a problem. So moving along, oh, I should mention too, I mentioned it was like 5 pounds. I actually weighed it, my scale said it was 6 ounces. So it seems a lot heavier than 6 ounces, but anyway. So I've got these guys cut out and big chunks off the blocks, and again, sanded up, cleaned up, and it'll go something like that. And you can see again, we've got some work to do down the seam. It's not going to be a perfect fit, and this one needed a lot of work, grinding and stuff. And I think I got to a spot where about best I can, and it's going to go something like that on this side. Tail's done too, like this, fit like that, and that is pretty much it. So I'm going to epoxy these three parts on, and then go back to more filling, and then we've got the main assembly done. Alright, so we've got the care of those seams, a little bit cracked, and I've got to fill it, it's a little bit sinking, at least to more touch up on this little bit on top here, but generally looking pretty good. It looks a little bit gnarly because obviously we know we haven't primed it yet, but hopefully when we prime, it's all going to look really good and uniformed. So wet sanded this. Now, I've never shown it, but let me kind of do a quick insert the video and you can see what I mean by wet sanding. So go across to the sink, get water running, and it just washes away all that dust straight down the sink, nice and clean, not over my bench. And that's my number one way of heavy sanding now. I just love doing it. I just find, especially Tamiya putty and this resin or plastic, just works really good with just wet sanding and with the sanding sticks. It just, the sanding sticks don't get clogged up. It just sands real easily. It gets nice and smooth. Again, no cleanup and super easy. So that's where we're at with the main fuselage here. And I did weigh, I mentioned earlier, it was about three to five pounds. It's actually 7 ounces according to my scales, which seem very light, but 7 ounces. And that big beast, big club right here. So, what else have I done? Well, I spent plenty of time cleaning up all the little parts, various parts here. This is for the right wing, various pylons and stuff. And most importantly, these big wings here, cleaned these up too. Packed away with my Dremel, my Proxon, and got to a stage where it's not a bad fit. But as you can see, there's definitely going to be some work needed down the seam there. You know, it'll fit okay, but it needs a lot of work for sure. Something like that. So yeah, I've got quite a gap to take care of on this side for sure. The right wing's not quite so bad, but definitely, again, something we need to fill and sand that little gnarly seam. And also, we've got the tail cleaned up, and that doesn't look so bad. So we're starting to look like a Viggen, if you can kind of imagine all these pieces together. Like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start epoxying again with this stuff, one at a time, getting these on and secure, and then once that's on, plenty more filling and sanding to get these in a reasonable shape, and then yeah, we'd be good to go. So next up, get these three main pieces here attached to the fuselage, and I'll be right back. There she is, looking like a Viggen. So we got the wings on, the tail. A little tricky, but we got on the end, and obviously epoxied. And one thing I note too is there, I realized it's 5 minute epoxy, so it takes 5 minutes to go off. And I've been holding things in place for like 3 minutes or so, and I was like, well, what's the point? So I learned to mix this up and just kind of spread it on, and just leave it for a few minutes, and then about 4 minute mark, then kind of hold it and place it and kind of line it up, because then I'm only holding it for a minute and not holding it for like 3 or 4 minutes. So I'm not really a big two-part epoxy user, so I didn't really think of that. So anyway, got this stuff on, I went down the seams, as you can see here, too, afterwards. I let them dry for like an hour, and then went back and added more down the seams. Not only as a filler, but also to get extra rigidity and make sure this thing's really solid and strong, because I don't want these things falling off. So I think we're in good shape. So that's how we're looking. Maybe zoom out a little bit more. There you go. You can see how big this guy is. Still got nose cone to go on, and really looking beast. A beautiful aircraft, and really happy how we're looking. So we obviously got some gnarliness back here. You know, seams, take care of front here. and obviously down the wings and the side and stuff. So what I'm going to do is, as I did the rest of this build, again, Tamiya putty, just going to spread it all down the seams, let it dry overnight, and we'll come back and we'll wet sand it all back, and hopefully, just like the front here on these intakes, it'll look just like that, and seamless, hopefully. Once that's done, then we can come talk about the canards and other parts as well. But the main part is really just get this stuff slapped on and let it dry and sand it away and get these seams really nice and looking better than they are now. I know I'm going to lose a lot of surface detail. Not a big issue. We'll come back and re-add that. But the main part is obviously get rid of these seam lines and get it blended and looking good. But yeah, big old beast and certainly looking like a Viggen. All right, just coming back real quick, and you can see the extent of the filler slapped on. So quite a lot going on there, and the other side, and the front, and again there. And also, I think I mentioned, snapped off somehow, lost the end of the wing here, so that needs to be a little plastic hard and fixed at some point too, later on down the road. So plenty of filler, let this dry again overnight, make sure it's fully dry, and also the epoxy stuff's fully dry for 24 hours too. And tomorrow I'll come back and I'll start sanding again the kitchen sink, get all this sanded back, and hopefully we're going to be in good shape and a lot of the dirty work is behind us. Okay, so sanding, filling, sanding, filling, sanding, filling, and I've got to a stage where I think it's okay, but I'm not going to know until I spray some primer down and see for sure. But we obliterated tons of detail back here down here, so a lot of scribing, rescribing to do along the seam where we kind of sanded, and yeah, there we go. So, not going to lie, it's kind of sapping the mojo a little bit, all the sanding, getting this together, but these are the main parts here, and I want to make sure they're right. Also, this was a real nightmare. It almost flew across the room. Remember the little part I was missing from the wing here? Add a little plastic card, thought I'd glue it on, no problem at all, and sand it back. Super glue wouldn't stick, then I tried epoxy, and then that was okay, but then a plastic card kept falling out from the inside. Threw a ton more super glue on top of the epoxy, and I think I got it. Needs a little bit more sanding. But yeah, it's just got a little piece on the end. I didn't know, realize it'd be such a big, big palaver. So anyways, this is how we're looking. Main assembly kind of done. We've got the canards to do, which I'll do offline. And I've got a bunch of rescribing to do, and then we can throw down some primer over the seams and see where we're at. I know we're going to need some more work. It's not going to be perfect straight off the bat, but without the primer, I can't really see exactly, you know, what we've got going on. So there she is again, big beast, big heavy Viggen. Hopefully you enjoyed the episode. If so, I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.